Stop using the print function in Python. There is no date and time information, no thread information, no class, no method, no line information. Instead, use the login library, and let's see how to configure it with just one line. That's it, I just need to get the logger. At each module, I want to log something and nothing more. But the login library can do a lot more for me. There are 5 log levels. Critical for unrecoverable errors which lead to a shutdown. Error for unrecoverable errors but the applications can continue. Warning for a user misuse of the application or for a degraded behavior. Info to trace a normal usage of the application. And debug to obtain a detailed information for debug purpose. With no configuration, that's all I can do. I will of course have a formatted log record with the timestamp, the module and the log level. For most of the cases, this can be enough, But what if I need to store my logs in some files? What if I generate too many files and I need to backup the files? Or to send the logs to external servers, to aggregate with multiple applications, or to send an email to the development team when some specific error appears? There are 3 main components in the login library: handlers, filters, and formatters. The handlers tell me how a log will be handled, printed into a file, sent via HTTP, sent via email, or more. The filters will specify which log will reach each handler, and the formatter will pre-print a log. Within the login library, each line of log comes into an object called log record. Each log record can have associated a list of handlers, depending on the logger name. Then the log record will be filtered, depending on the log level and some custom filters. Finally, the log record reaches the formatter associated to the handler. This gives me a lot of possibilities. Let's see 2 scenarios. In the first one, a typical one, I want to stream my logs into a file, but the file must be saved back into separated files every day. And in the second scenario, I want the application to send all the logs to an external server via HTTP requests. There are multiple ways to configure the loggers. I will use a dictionary because it's the most recent way and it accepts more customizations. At the moment of the video, only the first version is accepted, and this other option is to maintain all the implicit loggers. Let's start configuring the logger. Here will be located the filters, the formatters, and the handlers. In this last part, I assign to each logger, to each module, the handler to be used. This way, I only filter the logs coming from the backend module. This can be very useful when applying an expensive handler to the logs, as sending an email. I may just want to send an email with logs from the error module, or from the critical module. I can declare multiple formatters. Then, in the handlers, I will choose which one to use. To configure a formatter, I have about 20 parameters to use. And finally, those numbers allow me to create some columns of characters, to avoid having extensive names which overload the console. I've configured two handlers. The first one is the most used. Just stream the logs to the console. I indicate until which log level the handler will print and which format it will use. The second handler will save the logs into files, into time rotating files. This means that the file will rotate into a backup. When? Once a day. Finally, I indicate which handler and log level will use each logger. This is the root logger, the parent logger. All the loggers will inherit from it. Then, for some external loggers, as Flask, SQL Alchemy, or Vexjug, I only want warning or higher logs. This was my first scenario, saving my logs into files. Let's go now with my second scenario, streaming my logs to an external server. I maintain the console handler. It's always good to have this one for debug purpose. Then I've created an HTTP handler. Here is located the HTTP server where will be sent the logs. I will use the post method, and this is the URL where they will be sent. I have some other configurations, as the credentials and the SSL certificate. If I indicate a get method, the log record will send all the values in a query string. Using the post method, they will be sent using the form URL encoded format. And here is another handler. The HTTP requests may take some time to be sent. If my application generates a lot of logs and the HTTP requests are not fast enough, the application will slow down progressively, maybe saturating the network. For that, I've created a buffer, a memory buffer, which accumulates a given number of log records and send them to the specified handler, the HTTP handler. This creates asynchronous requests. But why this Z in the name? The login library isn't smart enough to detect that the buffer handler depends on the HTTP handler. The login library just sorts them alphabetically and builds them. Finally, I indicate which handler to use. The HTTP handler will be used by the buffer one. Let's make a quick recap of what was done. To add a logger into a module, just use this declaration. By default, the login library already formats my logs, adding the module name and the timestamp. Nevertheless, only the console handler is available by default. To configure the loggers, I've used the dictionary configuration. I can configure filters to indicate which log record will be handled. I can configure multiple formatters with multiple fields of the log record, then indicate at the handler level which formatter to use. Then I can configure multiple handlers, console, memory buffer, HTTP handler, queues handlers, email handlers, file handlers, etc. And finally choose which handler will use each logger. That's all for today. Don't forget to click on the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And see you in all videos. Bye!